Hello and welcome. This is the recording of the study guide for the course, this summer course in Applied IoT at Linnaeus University, the summer of 2021. My name is Fredrik Ahlgren and I'm the course coordinator for this course. So, let's start. Where do we find the study guide? Well, you find the study guide on our course homepage under the name study guide. The main reason that we have a study guide is that you will be able to find all relevant information and what you're supposed to do in one single place. So if there are anything that is unclear, let me know as soon as possible and we will try our best to change this. So let's go through the study guide. Important links. Course homepage. Obviously you are already there if you found the study guide, but you have that as well. We have the planning document. This is a document which we are going to be updating as we go during the course. So expect changes and we expect you to check the planning document. We will also distribute everything in beforehand in the Discord server, which is the next point on the list. And if you press the Discord server, you will get actually you're pressing an invite link to the Discord server. And if you've already logged in, it will take you directly to your logged in account. Please use your real name in the Discord server. You don't have to change your name. You can just change your nickname in this particular server, but I do want you to use your real name. Everything will be taking place in the Discord server, so it is super important that you join in to the Discord server. Then, everything will also be streamed at YouTube, where you are looking at this video also. We are going to put everything that happens here in one long playlist, which will be populated as we go. So please keep an eye on this playlist and you won't miss anything that is live. You can also press the little button down at the side with a little bell. That creates a reminder that is linked to your YouTube account. Also, I would advise you to actually subscribe to our computer science channel and you are sure not to miss anything. There are no other courses that are going to be broadcasting this summer, so you won't be bogged down by other notifications. We are going to use the Canvas learning platform. Linnaeus University has also my Moodle, but we are going to use Canvas learning platform in this summer course. The reason for that is that we have a pretty good peer review function in the Canvas learning platform that we do want to utilize. The learning platform is only used for the examination part. That means that we are actually not going to open up the Canvas learning platform until a week or two into the course. So don't be scared if you can't find anything behind this link. It will be opened up, don't worry. You will also find the IoT tutorial template. This template might change a little bit, but the majority will be the same. We will have yet another session about the IoT tutorial, which is your project work, which is the main form of examination in this course later on, but there is the template. You will find also the course syllabus. For those of you that like formalities, you will find all information in the syllabus here. We will also try to keep an updated frequently asked questions on HackMD. This is editable by everyone, actually including you. So you might want to contribute to this document as a open wiki document for the course. We also have a GitHub repository, which you can find some code snippets and examples that we have used before in earlier courses. Even this repository will be updated during the course. And I do encourage you all to actually put up a pull request if you have created something that you think is a good thing to share. If you don't know what I'm talking about, don't worry. This is an introductory course and you're not, you don't have to know what even Git is. Don't forget to subscribe to our computer science channel. Okay, my expectations from for this course. Well, my expectations from you. I want you to read this document carefully. This will be the main document that we actually sort of sign a contract together. This is what the course is, and this is what we agree upon when we start the course. So it's very important. Please give me feedback if anything is unclear. There are hundreds of people in this course, and if you don't understand something, most likely there are many as well that have the exact same problem. Plan your studies. Even though much is recorded, it's actually a good time to at least write in your calendar a good time that you, I try to watch this at this time. Please try to be active on all live sessions. It will make the course much better for everyone. And ask questions. We have set up this course in a kind of distributed environment on Discord. This means that it might be a bit harder to find information when you need it. So you're really encouraged to ask even twice or three times if you don't find the information. So we are many TAs and many teachers in the course. So please, please just ask away. And I must mention that there is a pretty decent search function as well in Discord. But well, please ask. And the next thing after that is answer questions. Obviously, we want you to be active. This is a course that you need to be active in. Active participation will count in this course. So please help out as much as you can. Answer a question if you see it right away. And interact with students and teachers at Discord. Don't be afraid to answer questions. And well, this may go without saying, but I'm saying it anyway. Please be nice and respectful. And the success of this course is really based upon your participation. Above all, and I must press this is the most important thing of everything I'm going to say here today. Adopt a positive attitude, and we are all here to have fun. That's really what it's all about. We do want to learn a lot of new stuff, and we do want to do that while having some fun while we're doing it. So please keep a positive attitude. Don't ever tell anyone else that they should know this. Just try to answer. And there are really no stupid questions. And I know that's what you usually say, and you've heard it before. So let's skip to the next part, the objective of this course. And this is important. The aim of this course is for you to build a connected sensor unit. So you need to measure something that is presented over the internet. So It could be even a simpler project, and it could be a very, very complex project. It's a very broad spectrum in the type of project that you can do in this course. But you need to build something that sends some kind of data, sensor data, over the internet. That's the basic level of this course that you really need to do. And I must say also that this course is an introductory course. We won't dive very deep into the different parts of this subject. We do only have a limited amount of time, and the prerequisites for this course is at introductory level, so we do have people in the course that never even have programmed before. So have that in mind. That doesn't make your projects less advanced if you want to, but you will have to do a lot of lifting yourself, I'm just saying. The course has a practical focus, and so this means that we do encourage you very much to work in a practical manner. That means that you need to buy stuff. You need to buy things in order to do this course. It's not the course when you open a book and write an exam. It's a course when you create something with your own hands, program something, and something happens in the real world. This is also one of the things that makes this course so particularly fun to work with. The material recommended is in the bill of material, which I'm sure you all have seen by this time. You should be This should all be procured before the start of the course. If you're unsure of anything, just ask. And of course, there is a possibility to use other kinds of devices. But if you're unsure, just ask. We do recommend the material for a reason. It's a good start. So the course material will be presented on this course homepage, and also some co in the GitHub repository, and the learning platform for the exams and the quizzes. All interaction will take place at the Discord. And as soon as we open up Canvas, you will be able to log in with your Linnaeus University student account. Now to the next section, the communication strategy. As this is a large course, we are many students, and we are many teachers, and we are many teaching assistants. It's very important that we keep the we have do have a we do need a communication strategy. So the first bullet point on this list is about personal questions. So if you have any personal questions like formal participation in the course, absence, grades, etc., that's really the only reason you have sending me an email as I see it. So you can obviously send me an email, absolutely, but try to keep the emails to an absolute minimum. So only questions that are very personal and regarding formal participation in the course are sent via email to me. Teachers will not accept any friend request at the Discord. And this is because we do not want a massive amount of direct messages popping up all day long. And we do also want to keep all the discussions in an open discussion as much as it's even possible. So it's not personal. Don't feel sorry if you didn't get that friend request from me or from my fellow teachers. It's really the way we have set up the course. Questions, all questions but course assignments, examination schedule, that's asked on Discord. And to make it very easy, you ask everything at the Discord server, really. We will post all information regarding the course will be posted in the announcement channels. So it is very important that you read everything that is announced in the announcement channels. If there are things that are important in even other channels, we might pin it. So that's a way for putting it up for better searchability. Discord is a fantastic tool. You can actually make individual changes on muting certain channels and unmuting others, such as that. But please keep the course announcement channel not muted, because that's the channel that we are going to use for distributing information to all of you. We won't be sending any emails in this course. Please also respond to all pinned posts. And by responding, I'm not meaning that you should say anything, write anything. It's, put a thumbs up or an emoji of whatever feeling you might have for the day. But please respond to all posts by some kind of emoji. Why is that? That's because it's a really good way for us in the management and also for you to see how many that have actually seen that message. So if I put out something in the course announcement channel and if I get 250 likes on that particular message, I can be pretty sure that many people have seen it. If I only get one, I might be a bit concerned. So please respond to all pinned posts at least. Please respond to as much as possible all the time. It's really not hard. It's just one click away. You can filter the pinned post according to the figure here. Yes. Just a note about the language in the course. We will be speaking English in this course if you haven't noticed it before. I do have Swedish as my native language, and we do have many teaching assistants that do have Swedish as the native language. And I do understand that there might be times when you're speaking with someone that speaks the same native language as you and it's not English. Please switch over to English as soon as possible, that so everyone feel included. And I would say it's better that you speak English even though you're two Swedes talking, because if you're speaking in a Discord channel and there might be someone that doesn't speak Swedish, that might feel a bit uneasy to join in if you're speaking Swedish. So please keep all discussions in English. It makes it easier, and see this as an opportunity to further strengthen your skills in the English language. Okay, let's go to the objectives. These are the same objectives as you find in the course syllabus, and I'm quickly going to describe what you're going to do. You need to fulfill all the objectives in the course to get a grade. That's how it works. You can't do, you can't miss out on any single one of them. But what we are going to do in this course is that we're going to have four quizzes. These are going to take place on Canvas. You will find more information about those later. The quizzes are linked to different objectives, learning objectives, as you see here. So we will have one quiz about 3D printing, as you can see down in below. That's Q4. And then we have the basic tutorial and the extended tutorial, and that's actually T1 and T2. The thing with this is that you have the choice of just aiming for a C, that's like the standard grade, and you can also aim for a higher grade, and that's when you do the extended tutorial. So it's really much the same. And also we have the oral presentation, as you can see here. And the oral presentation is for those of you that are aiming for higher grades. The deadlines, you will find all the deadlines in the planning document, which is, it's very clear. But the course starts at fourth Monday, the 14th of June. And we end in August with the last presentations. You need to do all the task before the course ends. Oh. After you have done your hand-in of the report, you will be assigned a peer review. And this peer review is an obligatory part of the course. The examination part. So, you will do a project tutorial which describes your project. And we are going to grade you in this manner, is that if you want a grade A, then obviously you need to fulfill the basic level, that's the T1 level, but then you also need to get like a 100% mark on your extended tutorial. You will also need to distribute your report publicly. I'm sure that most of you, even though you're aiming for just a lower grade, will do that as well. You will need to do the quizzes. And then we also have the complexity level, which is just a number here. We will have to discuss this in more detail later on. You need to do a presentation or a demo video, and you will need to have a very high participation. So those of you that are aiming for an A, which is the highest grade, you need not only to write a very good report, but you need also help to help out your fellow students and be active in the course. So, grade B, more or less the same, a little bit less complexity. I must say that most of you will end up at the C level, and that is that you're doing the standard package. If you aim for a higher grade than C, you need to present and discuss your project with a teaching assistant no later than 3 weeks after the course starts. So, and this is going to take place during the workshop sessions. That means that during the workshop sessions, about a week or two into the course, you make contact with the teaching assistant and say that you want to discuss your project. They will organize this in a good manner later. But this is important, as we are so many students in the course that we need to plan ahead in the presentation and the planning of the examination, as there is a little bit more work involved in the higher grade. And also it's a help for you to align your project so it meets the A or B level that you're aiming for. I call the profile, the grade AB, the profile projects, and that's an extra bonus for you. The grade doesn't really matter that much, I guess. What matters is that we will put all the best reports, the higher grade reports, in something called good examples. They will be distributed as the profile projects. And you can see these from last year. So it's a good way to showcase what you've done and also spread the knowledge further on. This goes without saying, but you need to do all tasks before the deadlines. Yeah. And the planning is found here. And as you see, we have a workshop schedule, and this might change, so don't look too close at what's behind me. But we do have some deadlines here with dates. And the course is about 10 weeks long, The first week of the course will be more of an introductory week and getting started. All lectures and workshops are planned at the evenings in Central European time. And we do plan all this between Monday and Thursdays. The only exception is the weekly video blogs, which be held at Fridays. And then there might be a one lecture that includes a teacher from the other side of the ocean, from North America. And then there might also be another time, but we'll come to that later on. So that's about it for the study guide. I hope that this was clear enough. Thank you very much.